In this video, you'll learn how to set a specific height and duration for jumping in platformer games, so that you can tweak those values instead of having to guess through trial and error. And you'll also learn how to vary jump height based on how long the jump input is being held. Howdy, and welcome to Game Endeavor. Often, in platforming games, the player will want to have specific control over their character's jump. It can feel clumsy and unresponsive to have your character overshoot a jump, especially if it's a very tall jump, or if they have to stop in midair so they can land where they want on a platform. With variable jumping, the player can instead release the jump at the proper time and land gracefully on the platform, which feels more fluid and pleasing to the player. This can also be a crucial feature in your game because of the various hazards you may have placed at their peril. If there are spikes overhead, for example, then the player may need to terminate the jump early to avoid getting a piercing headache. Handling this is actually pretty simple. Up until this point, we've been using a variable named jump velocity. To be more precise, this is actually the maximum velocity of our standard jump. So rather than extending the jump the longer the input is held, we'll instead cut the jump short if the player releases the jump button before they reach the maximum height. What you set velocity to after cutting off the jump will have a strong influence on the controls of your game. If you set it to 0, then the player will drop immediately after releasing the jump button. This will be super responsive, which may be ideal for hardcore platformers, but it won't look very smooth. To do this, we'll go into our input method and add an if condition to check to see if event is action released jump is true. However, we only want the player to be able to do this if they're jumping. Otherwise, they can do this on the way down from a jump or a fall, causing them to either hover in the air or do another minor jump. So we'll add an and condition to check to see if their velocity.y is less than 0, which means they're moving upward. If this condition is true, then we will set velocity.y to 0. This will stop their upward movement, at which point gravity will take over and immediately start pulling them back down. If you want this to not be so sudden, then we can set a minimum jump height for this. For example, we can set this to something like negative 500. So if velocity.y is less than negative 500, then set velocity.y to negative 500. This will make it so that early on in the jump, before the gravity has lessened the speed too much, we'll set it to this minimum, which has the effect of making the jump arc after it has been cancelled. And it also sets a minimum distance for how much we can jump, which is something to keep in mind because players often will just tap the jump button quickly instead of holding it. So if your minimum jump is too small, then it may feel awkward to the player. We'll leave these as hard-coded values for now because we will be returning to this in a bit once we can establish a specific distance for our minimum jump. The biggest issue I faced with platformers was constantly tweaking my physics, trying to make it feel right. Often, when we make platformers, we only use variables gravity and jump velocity and set these to arbitrary values. In this player controller, we currently have a gravity of 1200, but just looking at it on its own, it tells us very little. Jump velocity is negative 720, which again means little. But what if I told you that we could define our jump height and the time our jump should take, and then calculate gravity and jump velocity from that? Using kinematic equations, we can do exactly this. This is, in my opinion, the easiest way to tweak jumping, because if your gravity is too floaty, then just decrease the time a jump should last. The player's jump is too short, then just raise the jump height. I won't be getting into the nitty-gritty details of kinematic equations, so don't run off just yet. I'm just going to introduce you to the concept, show you a couple of equations, and then send you along your merry little way. To get started, we'll go ahead and create our variables. Since we now have the ability to vary our jump height, we're going to have min and max values for our jump height and jump velocity. So we need to rename our old jump velocity variable to max jump velocity, and create an extra min jump velocity variable. We'll be setting these at runtime, so to avoid confusion when reading this in the future, or for anyone unfamiliar with our project, we'll remove the values for gravity and max jump velocity that we assigned earlier. Then, we'll create our height variables, one named max jump height and the other min jump height. We need to set values for these, and like my move speed variable, I'm going to base mine on the size of my tile set, being 96 by 96. But rather than having times 96 all over my script, I'm going to create a singleton to store this value, because I will likely need to use this many more times in the future. To create a singleton, I'll make a new script called globals.gd, and in it, I'll declare a constant named unit size and set it to 96. Then go to Project, Project Settings, and then to the Auto Load tab. I'll find the path to the script I just made, and then add it. Now we can reference this anywhere in our project. which I'll do back in my player script by calling globals.unitSize. For the jump height, I want the player to at most be able to jump up 2 tiles, so I'll set a value of 2 times globals.unitSize. However, this would be a perfect 2 tile jump, which means there will be little wiggle room for the player to get onto the platform. This will be very frustrating to the player, so we'll give it a little extra space by making it 2.25. And for the minimum jump height, I want it to be around 1 tile, so that if the player just taps the button, then they will still be able to make basic jumps. However, a tap of the button will generally last longer than 1 frame, so we can go less than 1 tile with our variable. I will set mine to 0.8 times global unit size. Play around with this value to see what works best for you and your preferences. Now we need to set the duration for our jump. This will be in seconds and will be the time that it takes to reach the peak of the jump, and will be half the time for the jump in its entirety, because the time it takes to reach the peak of the jump and then fall back down are the same. So I'll make a variable named jump duration and set it to 0.5. A fun little fact that you should take note here is that since we know how long a jump will last, and in a previous tutorial I told you that my move speed variable is how much the player will move per second, and since we're not slowing the player in air, just lowering their acceleration and deceleration, we know exactly how far the player can jump, and thus the maximum distance that any pitch should be. In my case, the player will move 5 tiles per second, and a jump will last for 1 second. So I should not make any pits longer than 5 tiles apart from each other. 4 to be exact, because the edges of my tiles are not flush with the tile size. Plus, you should never be making pits where the jump needs to be perfect. Such jumps are extremely frustrating. So first, we want to be able to determine gravity, because it is needed for the other equations. So we'll create a ready method if you don't have one already. And in it, we'll set gravity to 2 times max jump height, divided by jump duration to the second power, which we'll get using the POW method. Now, we want to determine the velocities to use for our jump and variable jump. The equation to do this is to take the negative square root of 2 times gravity times the jump height, which for min and max velocities will be the min and max height, respectively. The height used in the equation sets us up for some interesting possibilities. For example, with this we can easily make a jump power up that will increase the player's jump height by 1 tile, which would just require using this equation again and giving it max jump height plus the bonus height, and then set a timer that will reset the player's jump velocity to normal. Now that we have our minimum jump velocity, we can return to our variable jump logic and replace our hard-coded values with our brand new min jump velocity variable. If you would like to learn more about game programming in Godot, then watch this video here. And if you're new, then join the sub club to get notified for future videos. And until next time, y'all take it easy.